YouTube, we're size 17 here, but you can just call me Travis. And welcome back to another collection update. Like always, I have nothing to say, so let's just jump into the music. In the background, we're listening to, I just showed this in my my most recent Up Next on the Shelf update, and I thought that'd be kind of a cool thing to throw on the background because it's a little different. This is the solo album Keep It Hid by Dan Auerbach, who you may know from the Black Keys. This is a solo album, kind of bluesy indie rock kind of stuff. It's pretty cool. You'll hear it. All right, got quite a number of CDs, so let's do it. First up, this is the new Cannibal Corpse, Red Before Black. This came out just this past Friday. A pretty big Cannibal Corpse fan. Probably, you know, in terms of just strictly, you know, straight death metal, probably my favorite death metal bands. You know, I like all of their albums, you know, obviously some more than others, but, you know, in terms of every individual album, there isn't one that I don't like. So, obviously, having an album come out from a band whose albums you all like, it's kind of cool. And, you know, if you're familiar with Cannibal Corpse, you know, they don't really do a whole lot of, musical progression from album to album. You know, they kind of write the same album over and over, which, you know, I'm kind of okay with. And this album, Red Before Black, no different. It's a Cannibal Corpse album. Listen to the first few tracks. I was maybe a little worried. I actually hadn't listened to any of the singles that they put out, like Code of the Slashers, which actually is kind of an ass song for me, so kind of glad that I didn't listen to it. But until we got to Shedding My Human Skin, then four songs in a row, Shedding My Human Skin, Remained, Firestorm Vengeance, and Head Shoveled Off, all four of those in a row, just totally was like, okay, no worries, Cannibal Corpse is here with a Cannibal Corpse album. And it made more sense once I went through the liner notes. Something very important, I think, that I did several years ago, I think probably around the time The Torture came out, is I really took the time to sit down with each album and really, you know, paid attention to who is writing each individual song. And something that I found out is that Alex Webster and Pat O'Brien songs, those are my two guys. And unsurprising to me, those four songs were written by just those two guys. In fact, I think three of the four are Pat songs. I think Firestorm Vengeance is maybe the only one that's an Alex song. But yeah, you know, that's not to say that only like Alex and Pat songs. Rob Barrett, who is, you know, the other kind of main songwriter in this particular era of the band, you know, he does solid work too. Just generally speaking, I don't like his stuff as much. I really liked Jack Owen when he was in the band as well. He did good stuff. But, you know, obviously since Alex has been in the band the whole time, that's a significant factor probably in why I like all of their albums. But, you know, Pat's been around for a while now. He joined on Gallery of Suicide, which was only one album after Corpse Grinder joined in Vile. So, you know, the dude's been around for a while writing awesome songs. Not too much going on the inside, you know, lyrics and stuff. By the way, does Alex Webster not look kind of like Kevin Nash of, you know, WWE and WCW fame, Diesel? I think he does there. Anyway, lyrics, photos, not too much else to say about this album. Kind of rambled a little bit there. But, you know, it's a typical Cannibal Corpse album. So, you know, if you are into listening to 12 more tracks, I think it's 12. 12 more tracks of Cannibal Corpse material that sounds like Cannibal Corpse material, then, this album's going to be right up your alley. They do not disappoint in that way. If I was forced to choose, I would say, at this point, it probably is a less stellar album than... you know, some of the most recent era, which I would say Kill and On, which is kind of like the Rob Barrett rejoined era. That's how I kind of look at it. Probably hovers around Torture, which actually I feel like a lot of people don't really like Torture a lot. But Torture also was sort of a lesser Cannibal Corpse album for me, and this album kind of is around that. But Kill is probably my favorite Cannibal Corpse album, actually. But I've only been listening to this for a few days, so obviously my taste might change. Not really into this album art either. Kind of feel like the recent, actually since Kill, the album art's been kind of lackluster. But regardless, Cannibal Corpse album, Red Before Black, like I said a million times already.
Feel like Cannibal Corpse, feel like this one.
Alright, next one up. This is another 2017 release. This came out, I think, maybe 2 weeks ago now. Maybe three. This is Mirror Reaper from Bellwitch. If you are not familiar with Bellwitch, they are a doom band from Washington State, actually. I really haven't spent a whole lot of time with this band, actually. I checked out their first full-length album, which I want to say was called Longing, maybe? And I remember liking it, but I kind of just it was one of those times where I listened to an album, I liked it, and I stopped thinking about it. And, I really have just been not keeping up with them at all. And, I was hearing about this, mostly this freaking gorgeous album art, which, you can kind of see a bigger picture in this gatefold section of the CD. This album art obviously is amazing, so that kind of drew my interest initially. But then, once I discovered that it was just one long track, like an hour and 20 minutes long, I was like, ooh, that really piques my interest. So I picked it up, and this is a really tough album to, or a song album to really kind of to dissect, have it being one song, although I will note that I'm not sure where it cuts off on the vinyl, because actually I think there's four, it's on four different sides of the vinyl, so it gets cut up, but this actually is, it's more than 80 minutes. This is out on two different CDs. Can't remember if there's anything to them. I think there's, that one has. Get my hand out of the way. It cuts, I think it's around the 45 minute mark is where the first CD splits. Luckily, I bought this on Bandcamp, so they also gave me a one whole song version, which is kind of cool to have. This is what the CD looks like. But yeah, anything that's that long and sort of super crazy, intense as a song that long would be, it's kind of hard to sort of dissect it up. I liken it to an album by Midnight Odyssey called it's the one after. Yeah, this one, Midnight Odyssey, Shards of a Silver Fade. This is two discs, a double album, and all the songs are 20 minutes long, or almost that long, or I think there may be some that are over 20 minutes long. This is just, it's so much material that it's sort of hard to, accurately encompass it all. In a thoughtful way, I don't know. Anyway, I digress about not being able to. Here's a line of notes, lyrics and credits and stuff. This is a very funeral doomy. Lots of really quiet acoustic sections and stuff. Just really cool. Like I said, I can't get over it. It's hard for me to really tell you what this album's about. I like it. It definitely sounds very funeral doomy. It also sounds it's a very sorrowful album, as if you follow the story of this album's sort of dedicated to the former member of this band who died. But I don't really know a whole lot about that other than the fact that that's something that happens. But yeah, there's just, it's a very emotive album. It may be less emotive, but it does a really good job of drawing emotion from you, I suppose, maybe. I don't know. I'm gonna stop talking about this album because, like I said, I can't really do a very good job of it, other than just to say it's good, it's awesome. You should, it's Juno Doom, Profound Lore, put this out. So yeah, check it out if you like Funeral Doom stuff.
I think it's good.
I did think it was interesting that you know, usually this is where the front of the album would be, but it's this is the cover. I don't know. Anyway. Yeah, Mirror Reaper by Bellwitch, Cool, Sorrowful, Funeral Doom from, I think these guys are, oh no, yeah, never mind, they're from Washington State. Wow. Stop talking about.
Good, you're done.
Alright, next up, this is the new one from Perturbator. This is New Model. If you're not familiar with Perturbator, he's kind of a electronic artist, dark wave. I would say a guy out of France, James Kent, I believe is his name. This is the new EP. What is it? Six songs? Yeah, six songs. I don't know if you can see on the inside of there. It says Blood 200 and Void 001. I didn't know what that meant. And then when I looked online, it was like, oh, it's the catalog number for Blood Music and... I don't know, like void of something, I can't remember. So that's what that is. Not much else going on with this other than just the CD and the packaging, and you got some song titles in the back there. You know, this is, you know, if you enjoy his other work, you'll enjoy this too. I would say this one has, maybe that's just due to lack of aesthetics of the packaging. This one seems to have less of a... story, movie, soundtrack aspect to it. It sort of just sounds like electronic music songs, which is fine because it still sounds really awesome. And, you know, kind of a seedy, dark, and grimy stuff. But yeah, you know, really cool stuff. If you like the other Perturbator albums, you'll like this. There's no doubt. Kind of, you know, if anything, it kind of leaves me wanting more since it's just an EP. But I don't know, maybe he's got something coming out soon, maybe next year, who knows. But yeah, New Model, Perturbator, pretty cool stuff, definitely worth checking out. Alright, this next one up, I was super excited to get a copy of it. It had been previously sold out, and I had been searching and searching, you know, for a reasonably priced one. It was coming up empty, and then I came across... Import Music Warehouse is what it's called. It used to be known by CD Enzane, a distro or label out of Minnesota. And anyway, they had a copy of Nasty by Nature by Stereo Nasty. This is the debut full-length album from a heavy metal band, new wave of traditional heavy metal band out of Ireland. I showed off their album from this year, Twisting the Blade, off maybe, I don't know, 3-4 weeks ago. That album is really awesome. You should check it out. And this one is, you know, I had listened to it previously already. But, you know, now that I really had gotten the CD myself, I was super impressed. You know, it's really good. I think I probably like both albums about the same. I think they're both really solid, solid heavy metal records. I don't know, Stormspell records. Yeah, I think what it is... The guitarist of this band, his guitarists are just like super hooky, and you know, every time a song starts off, you're just immediately hooked by the riff, and there's no letting go. I also enjoy the vocals. It's kind of a cool gravelly singing voice, which, you know, is unique. Not a lot of guys are doing it, but I'm hearing anyway in this genre, and I think it's done very, very well. In particular, I would say all these songs are good, but the first four songs, Black Widow, Holy Terror, Interstellar, and The Fear, are all just rippers of songs. All of them are just full of riffs and good soloing, and yeah. By the time you're done with those first four songs, you are in for the long haul. And that's not a big deal anyway, because the rest of the album's good too. But yeah, I did notice actually now that I paid a little bit more than maybe a typical CD, but still, it was a reasonable price. I did notice that Stormspell Records actually came across some lost stock, and this was one of the albums that you can get there, so $9.99 if you would like to get a copy of this over at Stormspell. Definitely worth that price. So if you would like to get this record, I would jump on it quick, because I'm sure those will sell out very quickly. I checked this morning to see but that was many, many hours ago now. But anyway, yeah, again, Nasty by Nature, by Stereo Nasty. This album's awesome. I'm really into these guys a lot. And yeah, again, check out their new album, Twisting the Blade. It'll definitely be in my top 30 of the year. So yeah, Nasty by Nature, Stereo Nasty. And this was thrown in with the order, which was kind of cool. In doing some research, the label Import Music Warehouse, or whatever it's called, and then previously CD and Zane, was run by a guy named Zane Peterson, who is the drummer in this band called Malicious. This is their debut full-length album. It seems that it was released in like 1993, if I remember correctly, on a very small quantity on cassette tape, and this is a re-release on CD, obviously, done in 2011 on CD in Zane. Yeah, this is, traditional heavy metal. I do want to say there's a little bit of a glam vibe to this, a little bit, maybe. I'm not too versed in glam outside of, just, like, knowing of the, subgenre, and knowing the popular bands and stuff that played it, they're playing knowing their hits at least. But anyway, I listened to this once. I didn't really spend a whole lot of time with it, but it sounded solid. I did notice some solid riffing and soloing in there, without spending a whole lot of time really thinking about it. But I'll listen to this a little bit more. But kind of cool to have this thrown in regardless. So yeah, thanks. All right, next up, this is a reissue of In Hours Beneath by Anephrens. This was just released through Brian Drune Recordings, Nordvis Productions. This is an album that came out last year. If you're not familiar with this band, this is a kind of a doomy post-black metal folk band. Folk metal band out of I think he's now in Minnesota. He previously was in Montana. But anyway, this album came out last year. I saw it earlier in the year on Bandcamp and liked it, and then waited too long, as it was self-released. I waited too long and eventually sold out. Lyrics on the inside, credits on the back. And it was sold out, and I kicked myself. And when I had picked up, he reissued his another album from last year, The Inward Cold, which I immediately picked up. When I showed it off in my collection update, someone who watches my videos, Saritwad, at some point he watched that video and noted that I had said in the video that I would love to get a copy of this, or at least I think that's what happened, if I remember. I don't, maybe I made that up. Anyway, he commented to me that, hey, dude, I don't know if you know this, but Bind Rune is reissuing this album, and I did not know that, and I went there and I pre-ordered it immediately. This just arrived on Friday, and I hadn't listened to it, since earlier in the year, and this album's awesome. I thought it was awesome. One thing I thought was cool is that sort of my introduction to having material by this band was the four-track acoustic EP, Eventide, that he put out. I did not really think about it or realize it, but the song Mourning is one of the songs he did for that four-track EP, which I was kind of cool to me to hear. I hadn't realized it was a reimagined version of the song. So that was cool. The CD version of this comes with a bonus track called Erase or something like that. I don't think this is even on the vinyl. I think it's just on the CD. So that's pretty cool. I'm into bonus tracks because you never know if you're going to get a really cool song. This one's, you know, it's a solid Nevers track. Nothing that I thought was super, super amazing. But, you know, that's cool nonetheless. But yeah, I really like this album. I think maybe I like it maybe just a little bit more than The Inward Cold. But, you know, it's early on. But the songs, Chrysanthemum especially, and Through the White, I really like those ones a lot. Morning Again, great song. But all in all, just, you know, really cool stuff. I really enjoy Jory's clean vocals are just awesome. He has a great, great soothing voice. I kind of like the doomier grunt style vocals as opposed to a more black metal shriek style, something that you might get in a post black metal style act. But yeah, you know, not much to really say about this album other than, yeah, you should hop over onto Bindroon and pick up yourself a copy of this album because it's awesome and you should have it.
All right.
One more, and this is an album that I'm super excited to have added to my collection. This came out last year, digitally only, and, you know, I've been long awaited for the physical release to come out. And all of a sudden it was like, I think early, maybe mid-September, and maybe early September. All of a sudden it was like, oh, it was released like a few weeks ago in August. And I was like, oh shit, I don't know how that happened. And I actually missed out on the cool limited big box version of it, which I totally would have purchased. But anyway, happy to have this awesome CD digipack version regardless. Enough avoiding the topic. This is the new one from Merkgrav, Tok og Farvel, Tida or Blit I Anen, which I'm sure I am saying that wrong. It is in a it is in Norwegian. This is out on Pest Productions, and I think they're a Chinese label. Yeah, if you're not familiar with this band, this is a folk metal band out of Norway. It's a one man project. Lars. What is his last name? Lars Jensen. The first full-length album, Trollskau Skrømt og Kolderbrennen, if I remember that correctly, is like one of my all-time favorite albums. Definitely my favorite folk metal album. That's just a killer record. And, you know, this one has been released several years after that one. And, you know, it was long, I think, I don't know if it was true or not, but rumored that, you know, he was sort of like, you know, not interested in doing another album. I don't know if that was just lack of interest in doing music or trying to live up to the amazingness that is Troska Skrømt og Kolderbrenning. But anyway, lo and behold, we have another release. As I said, this came out last year, I want to say like maybe in October. I actually avoided listening to it. I said I'm going to wait until the physical version comes out before I listen to it. And, you know, I was starting to get to the point where I was going to break that because I wasn't sure if it was actually going to happen. But, yeah, this album is an awesome follow-up to that first full-length album. This is definitely similar style. Maybe the folkiness, you know, in terms of the instruments that are being played, like violins and stuff like that. Definitely, it's perhaps ramped up compared to the first album, but that's pretty cool. I think it fits well with the album. There's a couple of, I think maybe three songs on here. I'm not going to pronounce them, but yeah, I think it's either two or three songs on here that are redos of songs from the first album. There's a couple of songs on here that are like instrumentals. A couple of them that are like English versions of the same song, or ones like you know, one's a harsh version, one's like a softer version. I don't know. It's just like a cool. It just really fits. It really fits the overall style and aesthetic of this album. Here's the picture behind the CD. Lars is, you know, like with the first album, his harsh vocals are great, his clean vocals are great, his arrangements are awesome. I thought this was, let me go back, we got some credits here in a picture, and then on every page for a song, we get Norwegian and English lyrics. So that's pretty cool. If you're into lyrics, you can go through and actually know what they're saying if you don't know Norwegian and you know English. Then we also get a picture. I didn't go through the lyrics myself, so I'm not sure if the pictures go with the songs. I will assume they might, but I don't know that. Anyway, large vocals, awesome. The harsh stuff is good. Clean stuff's good. The music compositions are great. The guitars sound awesome. The drums sound awesome. The folkiness sounds organic and true. If you if you're into folk metal, I highly suggest you check out both this album and the first one. And if you've listened to the first one, definitely check out this one. While I don't think it lives up to that album, that's a pretty high bar, and this one certainly is definitely worth your time. No complaints at all. Just another solid, great folk metal record. Nothing too cheese or whimsical, that kind of folk metal. Just very solid, traditional sounding stuff. Very, very cool. I don't know if this guy's going to continue doing music or what, but with two awesome records under his belt, who knows if he really needs to. Obviously, I would love if he did, because I like his material. But anyway, this is the new one by Myrkgrav, Tok Og, Farvel, Tida, or Bitten Al Anen. Again, I'm sure I butchered that, but that's how things go around here. You can pick this up. I picked it up on Bandcamp. I think you can also pick it up on the Pest Productions website. Again, I haven't checked it, so maybe this shit's sold out. I have no idea. But if it's not, you should jump on it, because this is a great album. Yeah, definitely check this out. The only thing I want to say before I go off here, nothing else to show. Obviously, the new Acid Witch came out on Halloween. Obviously, only the digital came out. The physical version is not coming out until I think the end of December. So I'm actually really glad that it's coming out in the year of 2017. So I didn't really want to talk about it in this collection update, as I'm not actually showing a physical release. Though I do want to talk about it. Last night, being really smart, I did a review of the album while drunk, and I'm not sure if I like how it turned out. Maybe I'll post that, maybe I won't. But I would like to talk about the album. I'm just not going to do it in this video. So yeah, that's enough about that. Thank you for watching. Thank you for subscribing. If you are familiar with any releases I showed today, please let me know what you think of them. Otherwise, hope everyone had a great weekend. Mine was pretty good, other than Jason Hook's stupid football team being stupid. Otherwise, everyone have a good night. Good day. Whatever.